Wisdom, the final frontier to true knowledge. Welcome to Wisdom Trek, where our mission is to create a legacy of wisdom, to seek out discernment and insights, to boldly grow where few have chosen to grow before. Hello, my friend. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, your captain on our journey to increase wisdom and create a living legacy. Thank you for joining us today as we explore wisdom on our second millennium of podcast. This is day 1403 of our trek and time for our Philosophy Friday series. Each Friday, we will ponder some of the fundamental truths and mysteries of life and how they can impact us in creating our living legacy. As we continue on this trek we call life, sometimes we have questions about life, so our Friday trek is a time where we can ask Gramps. Gramps will answer questions that you would like to ask your dad or granddad, but for whatever reason, this is not possible. No matter how old we are, I know that all of us would like the opportunity to ask Dad or Gramps questions about life in many areas. We may mix it up a bit on our Friday episodes, but we'll strive to keep them down to earth and enjoyable. If you have any questions that you would like to ask Gramps, please email them to guthrie@wisdom-trek.com. Earlier last month, we addressed a question that is just too broad to answer in one episode. The answer today is a fourth in a series that will span several weeks, which I will address on our Ask Gramps episode about the long-term economic effects of the pandemic. Please make sure you download our Friday podcast sessions to follow the complete analysis. Better yet, subscribe to Wisdom Trek so that you can gain wisdom 5 days a week. So here is the question that was asked. Hey Gramps, I realize that after this whole COVID-19 pandemic is under control, life will get back to some sort of normalcy for most people. I just can't get my mind around how life will change with so many people out of work and many businesses not being able to survive. What is your take on how life will be after COVID-19? So today's segment is Life After COVID-19, Part 4. Our analysis so far has been the overall jobs in manufacturing, brick and mortar retail, and the restaurant industry or future dining. As I mentioned in the past 3 weeks, I do not have a crystal ball nor any prophetic message about life after COVID-19. But that being said, I do have 40 years of experience in business and technology and nearly 64 years of experience of life, which helps me to see what others may not. The core of the content today and in subsequent weeks comes from a book and a companion blog written by Peter Diamandis. His book, The Future is Faster Than You Think, was published in January of this year before the COVID-19 really became an issue. Peter has recently stated that the COVID-19 would accelerate his predictions significantly. I do recommend this book for a good read. Let me once again offer some perspective. It has been said that crises don't much alter the course of history as accelerate the changes that are already underway. Exponential technology has been disrupting traditional industries at an ever-increasing pace. The pandemic has put these changes into hyperspeed. Never have we had the opportunity to rewrite entire sectors, redefine the problems they address, and reinvent their solutions. For many, this is a scary time, but it is also the most exciting time to be alive. Any time that we have a disaster such as this, there is also unlimited opportunities. The next economic sector that we'll explore today is commercial real estate and offices. What is the impact? The commercial real estate market is about to take a severe hit, and the real estate domino effect will topple adjacent financial institutions as well. As thousands of companies race to digitize, offices are rapidly migrating to digital platforms, dematerializing entire divisions and corporate campuses. A top-performing executive team coach, who is Keith Fiorazzi, prophetically remarked a few weeks ago, "We are not going back to work after the pandemic. We are at work, and for many, it will be more efficient and cost-effective than ever before." The convergence of 5G, Wi-Fi Gen 6, video conferencing services such as Zoom, Microsoft, and Cisco, and new collaboration tools such as Slack are making the workforce more productive at home, freeing up an hour or more of commute time each day. So what are some of the entrepreneurial opportunities? Today, let's consider two possibilities. The first is to go digital/virtual. If you are a traditional company with a few hundred employees who clock in every day and work from a desk, maybe it's time to reconsider dematerializing your office. Consider the economic trade-off. What does that office space cost you? What would happen if you canceled your lease, pumped 80% of those savings into profits, and took the remaining 20% to give to your employees for a stipend for better bandwidth for their home or a more comfortable desk chair? Or if you really want to peek into the future, consider following the lead of Glenn Sanford. He is the CPO of eXp Realty, which is the first ever cloud-based real estate brokerage firm. Glenn utilized a virtual platform called Virbella, which he now owns, to build out the company's mega campus in VR, or virtual reality. eXp Realty demonstrates the power of dematerializing workspace, throwing out the hefty overhead cost, and fundamentally redefining what real estate really means. 10 years later, eXp Realty has an army of over 14,000 agents across all 50 U.S. states, 3 Canadian provinces, and they have 400 MLS market areas, all without a single physical office. You might want to check out the platform Virbella, V-I-R-B-E-L-A, to see what it would be like to have a virtual company. The second opportunity we want to look at today is the live/workspace. If you are an owner of commercial real estate, get ready for a rocky future. What do you do as renters start to cancel on you? What happens when prices plummet? One idea you might consider is turning offices into a combination of a live/workspace, if zoning allows, whereby you can offer startups the opportunity for the employees to live and work in joint environments. Imagine comfortable 1 or 2 bedroom apartments in combination of open offices, conference rooms, and a central kitchen and dining area, and a shared social lounge. This might seem a bit far-fetched, but it's not too far, but it's starting to be practiced today and a movement I think that will continue. Now is the time to act if you are in the commercial real estate market or related industries. It will radically change and consolidate over the next 10 years. There are no guarantees in life, but we must be wise and make decisions that are based on wisdom that we have obtained. Today I have mentioned a couple possible opportunities for you. And the verses I want to look at today is taken from James chapter 4, verses 13 through 16. And James said, "Look here, you who say, today and tomorrow we are going to a certain town and will stay there a year. We will do business and make a profit. How do you know what your life will be like tomorrow? Your life is like a morning fog. It is here a little while, and then it's gone. What you ought to say is, if the Lord wants us to, we will live and do this or that. Otherwise, you are boasting on your own pretentious plans, and all such boasting is evil." We are still just scratching the surface of some of the accelerated changes that will be seen in the next few years. Next Friday, we'll explore more areas of transformation that is to come. Specifically, we'll focus on education, which we will see a lot of change in the next few years. And that's a wrap for today's question. Join us again next Friday as we expand on this question on our Ask Gramps episode. Our next trek is Meditation Monday, where we will help you to reflect on what is most important in life. So I encourage your friends and family to join us, and then come along with us on Monday for another day of Wisdom Trek, Creating a Legacy. If you'd like to listen to any of the past 1,402 daily treks or read the associated journals, they are all available at wisdom-trek.com. And I encourage you to subscribe to Wisdom Trek on your favorite podcast player so that each day will be downloaded to you automatically. And thank you so much for allowing me to be your guide, your mentor, but most importantly, I am your friend as I serve you through the Wisdom Trek podcast and journal each day. And as we take this trek of life together, let us always live abundantly, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and leave a living legacy each day. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, reminding you to keep moving forward, enjoy your journey, and create a great day every day. See you on Monday.